So we've got a multifunction tester, we've got our Megger 1711, and we're going to be measuring the resistance of the circuit during that continuity test. So if you've got a slightly different tester than me, you're still looking for the omega symbol or ohms, and that's the scale we need to set it on in order that we can measure the continuity or the resistance of a conductor. So if I rotate that round, we'll see our machine comes on, and it's a case then of sorting out our leads next. So our machine's on and working. We've got our leads. Again, we need to do a bit of a visual inspection of these before we use them. So just have a little once over, check there's no nicks or damage in them, okay, as you get those leads out of your box. And that's really important in a college setting, that you have a good once over on those leads, even though it is a dead test. If they've damaged the leads, obviously it's going to cause a problem with the results. So we've got our leads, and I'm going to be using the red and the green one. If you've got a different color lead or a different end, it doesn't really matter, but we like to keep them logically with color. And that's also with the connections in the top of the 1711. We're going to be using these two here. So it wouldn't matter what color leads we had, but we're going to be using the red and the green section here. And we always like to keep them the same, don't we? So we're going to put the green one in the green, but it wouldn't matter if it was the red. And obviously the red one in the red, it wouldn't matter if it was the green. So we've got our leads ready to go. And now we're going to remove the resistance of these. Well, we've currently got the tips on them, which I will use, and I'll use the crocodile clips as well. But just for removing the resistance, I'm just going to swap them over to the crocodile version of the leads, and then we're going to start by removing the resistance of the stuff that we're going to be using in circuit. These leads themselves are made up of copper, so of course they offer resistance and will need removing. And in early videos I did on the channel, I used to use a link like this in order to link in my consumer unit the line and CPC together. And I use those, so I would have to remove the resistance of these crocodile clips and obviously the link here that offers resistance. But I've moved away from that recently and started trialing this, which is our R1, R2 link. Okay, so I'm started using this for a college setting especially, because this end here is magnetic and will go onto the top of my MCB for my lighting circuit. And then I've got a crocodile clip here, which I can link onto my earth bar where my CPC is connected. But of course, I must remove the resistance of these as well. So if I insert them into my leads, it doesn't matter which way around they go. So I've got those inserted there. So I've now got the resistance of the leads and the link all in circuit. We heard the machine make a beep. Our continuity reading is 000. So it's saying it's already zeroed out. If that was a flashing zero, we would be below zero. But at the minute that that's saying zero, well, let's clear that by pressing the test button. So let's press the test button once. You notice now we have a reading. So that would be a reading that would need to be removed. How to remove the resistance of the leads? There's a test button on both sides of the machine. It wouldn't matter which one we pressed. So if I press this one just here, we press it and you see we've got zero. So we've removed the resistance of both the leads, the crocodile clip and this link. So we're ready to perform the continuity test where we'll measure the resistance of just the conductors in circuit and not the resistance offered up by the leads and the link.